This apparatus of beakers and funnels simulates the flow of a sucrose solution in the phloem of a plant. The funnels and connecting tube represent a sieve tube of the phloem. Differentially permeable membranes cap the funnels at the source and sink ends, allowing water, but not sucrose, to cross. Let's consider an experiment in which each funnel contains the same low concentration of sucrose. Water diffuses by osmosis into both funnels equally. Since neither funnel takes on more water, there is no net movement of the solution in the tube. As internal pressure builds, water no longer enters either funnel. Similarly, in a phloem sieve tube that contains equally low concentrations of sucrose along its length, a small amount of water enters the phloem by osmosis. However, the water enters equally along the length of the sieve tube, so there is no net movement of sucrose. In an experiment in which one funnel contains a high concentration of sucrose and the other contains a low concentration, water initially diffuses into both funnels, but soon only diffuses into the source end. As water flows into the source end, the solution is pushed through the tube and water is forced out the other end. Now consider a sieve tube that contains a high concentration of sucrose at one end and a low concentration at the other. Water initially flows by osmosis into both ends, but flows much more abundantly into the source end. This incoming water at the source end pushes the sucrose solution through the tube.